Hi friends, welcome you. Now today I am going to start one more chapter. We have finished this thing, trigonometry and quadratic equations. Today I am going to start one more chapter called the surface areas and volumes. Surface areas and volumes. This comes under what we call in mathematics, there is a branch called mensuration. Now it comes under that. Here the measurements, we'll take the measurements. Now this we require in our day-to-day work, day-to-day life, we require this. See, for example, let us say we have to get our home painted. Our home is to be painted. We are going for painting. Now, the painter quotes his rate on square meter, per square meter, so many rupees per square meter. So many rupees per square meter. So we have to find out how many square meters is to be painted, how many square meters are is to be painted. So for that we will have to calculate what we call the surface area of the walls. Similarly, if we want to construct a house, a building, now we want to know how many solid blocks or bricks are necessary, then we have to find out the volume of all the walls that we are going to construct, then the volume of the entire building divided by all the walls that are there in the building divided by the volume of each brick or each block gives you the number of blocks that we have to purchase. Now the rate of the blocks will be in so many rupees per thousand piece. Per piece it is so much, like that it will be there. So we come across many such problems in our day-to-day work. In a building, for example, we have to fix doors and windows. Wood or timber is necessary. The timber is quoted on volume, so many rupees per cubic meter. You know, the area of a plane figure or area, surface area, will be given in square meters, or it is written as meter square, and the volume is given in cubic meters, or it is written as m cube. In metric system we give it as cubic meter. So surface area will be always in square meters and volume will be in cubic meters or cubic centimeters or cubic millimeters, depending upon what they give. Now here we use certain formulae are used. You know some solids. Now, for example, you know what a cuboid is. Cuboid will be like this. This is called a solid, like this is called as the cuboid. This is called the cuboid. Now, it will have three measurements: length, width, and height or thickness, whatever you call. Now, there will be six faces. Totally there will be six faces. Now the area of two faces will be L into B, two faces, B into H, two faces, that is this will be B into H, two such faces will be there. L into B will be bottom one and the top one, L into B, and there will be two faces of L into H. So the total surface area will be this multiplied by 2. This will give you the total, what we call the total surface area. In surface area you get two types. One is the total surface area and the other one is curved surface area. So the formula slightly differs. Then volume will be equal to L into B into H or L into B into T, so many cubic meters or cubic centimeters or cubic millimeter, this will be given in square meters. Always the surface area is given in square units and volume is given in cubic units. So we have to use these things. Now, sometimes I told you that there are two types of surface areas. One is called the curved surface area and the other one is called the total surface area. Suppose I am making a pipe out of a sheet, out of a metallic sheet, I am making a pipe. Now, if I am making a pipe, it is cylindrical. So it is like this. It is cylindrical like this. Now, this is a pipe. I want to know how much sheet is required here. Here, I am not, if it is a pipe, there is this end and that end will not be closed. They will not be closed. So I have to find only the surface area. How to find the surface area? If you cut this sheet and open it, it will be a rectangle. It will be a rectangle. This will be equal to L, that is the length of the pipe, and this will be equal to the circumference of its base, that is, this will be 2 pi r. So the formula for surface area is 2 pi r into L. Now here, that is the area of this rectangle. If I open that, it is called the development. The development of a pipe will be a rectangle. See here, I will show you. Suppose this is a sheet from which I am going to make a pipe. Now this is the pipe. This is the length here. Now this is this circle. If you open this, it will be a rectangle like this. This will be 2 pi r and this will be equal to length. So a rectangular sheet will be required. Now the area of that rectangular sheet will be 2 pi r into L, the area of a rectangle. Now here, if it is a pipe, we don't close this, you don't close that, only this area. Suppose instead of pipe, I am making a can. Now we get juices, etc. in cans. If you are making that, then it is also cylindrical. It is also cylindrical. Cylindrical like this. It is also cylindrical. It is also cylindrical. So now this is also cylindrical. Here this will be dotted. Cylindrical like this. This is called H or L. You see, if I keep this like this, this length is called the length of the pen. If I keep it like this, it is called the height of the pen. Pen. Both height and length are same. Now here, if it is a can used for packing juice, then you have to have the lid at the bottom, you have to have a lid at the top. Here, it will be same 2 pi r into L, that is the central portion, plus you have to have a circular plate here and a circular plate here. So now, what happens is this radius is, its radius is r, this is also r. So 2 pi r into L, 2 pi r L plus 2 pi r square, that is the area of this circle is pi r square, the area of this circle is pi r square. So it will be 2 pi r L plus 2 pi r square. I can take 2 pi r as common factor, then it will be L plus r will be left here. 2 pi r, if I take as common factor, it will be 2 pi r into r plus L or L plus r. Now it is called as the total surface area. So it depends on what type of product I am going to make. Depending upon that, the formula differs. It can be either curved surface area or total surface area. Now, generally, the solids which we get are of regular shapes. That is, it may be a cuboid, it may be a cuboid, it may be a cylinder, it may be a cone, or it may be a prism, any shape prism, pyramid, sphere, hemisphere. Hemisphere means half sphere. Now these are the normal this thing. Now even cylinder is a prism. Prism with a circular base. If it is having say square base like this, a square base, then this is called as a square prism. A square prism. This is called as a square prism. Now cylinder is also a prism. It is a circular prism, but since it comes very often, we treat it separately. This will be treated separately. This we don't use this. Now pyramid, a cone is also a pyramid, but its base is circular. Now you see, you have triangular pyramid, hexagonal pyramid, square pyramid, like that. You can have a square pyramid also. See, like this, if it is called as a square pyramid. Now same thing, if it is having a circle here at the base, then it becomes a cone. It is called as a cone. So like that. Now there are different formulae for different solids, and depends upon whether you want total surface area or the curved surface area and the volume. The different formulae will be there for that. Now generally for sphere you will get only one surface area, surface that is total surface area. There is no curved surface area. Here it will be 4 pi r square, where r is the radius of the sphere. And for a hemisphere, there will be two. Curved surface area is 2 pi r square, half of that. If it is total surface area, that is bottom also is taken, then it will be 3 pi r square. Pi r square. If it is volume, the volume will be here 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube. Volume of a hemisphere will be 2 by 3, that is half of this. 2 by 3 pi r cube. So many cubic meters are this thing. Normally these solids we get. Cylinder, it will be, surface area will be, I told you, it will be 2 pi r into L or H, depending upon what you call it, cylinder. Then this is curved surface area. Curved surface area. Then if it is total surface area, it will be 2 pi r into r plus L, if it is total surface area. If it is volume, volume will be pi r square h. Pi r square h. Now for cone, in the case of a cone, you get two heights. This is, this height is called h, the vertical height. Vertical height. This is called the vertical height. And this is called the slant height. Slant height. Now, here L means only one length or one height. You can call it as either L or H. Whereas in a cone, this is different. In a cone, H and L are different. H is called the vertical height and L is called the slant height, the inclined height. Now, they are related. How they are related is, you see, this is a right angle triangle here. So, L square will be equal to H square plus R square, or L is equal to square root of H square plus R square. Now, this relationship you can use to find out L if you know H and R, or if you want to find out H, if you know L and R, you can use this relationship, you can do it. Now, here for curved surface area, the formula is 2 pi RL. Now, where you get that? Suppose we are going to make a tent out of canvas for some military people to stay in a forest during a camp. You are going to make this thing. how much canvas is necessary, how much cloth is necessary if you want to know. You will not put the canvas for the base. You will put the canvas only around. So that will be 2 pi RL. If it is total surface area, that is base is also taken, then it will be 2 pi RL plus pi R square. That is this bottom this thing. Then its volume will be pi R square H. This will be the volume. Here pi R square H divided by 3. Now here H means vertical height, L means this slant height. You should remember that. Here L and H both are same. Apart from this, this for prism and pyramid, any other shape prism pyramid comes, here volume will be area of base into height. This will be pyramid will be area of base into height divided by 3. Usually it will not come. For cuboid I gave you, if it is total surface area, it will be 2L plus 2B plus 2BH. If it is volume, it will be L into B into H. Then one more solid that we may come across in this chapter is the frustum of a cone. That is, if I have a cone like this, this is a cone. Sometimes I will cut this like this. I will cut it and remove this. Then it is called the frustum of a cone. This will be a frustum of a cone. Here also I will put. This will be a frustum of a cone. Now here, this is H. From here to here, center of this to center of this, it is vertical height. Again, this is slant height. This is called slant height. When you are finding the surface area, here there will be two radii. One is R1 and the other is R2. There will be two radii, R1 and R2, you will get. So here it will be, curved surface area will be 2 pi L into R1 plus R2. This will be the curved surface area. If it is total surface area, you have to take this as well as this. Now this comes in, say, a funnel, when you are making a funnel or a bucket or a dustbin, some of the shape, then you will use that formula. And the volume will be given by 1 by 3 pi h into R1 square plus R2 square plus R1 R2, like that. This is the formula. So these formulae will be there. Now, if you are using them continuously, if you use them, you will be able to by heart that. They will come automatically by heart. They are there in your book also, you find them. If you are using these formulae and working out some problems, you will get it. Now, I will take up, sometimes you get a combination of solids. It may be a combination of two solids. For example, If you have a tank like this, it is cylindrical from here to here. This is half sphere, that is half sphere. So totally it becomes two spheres. And this is the center portion is a cylinder. Now if you get like this, then you will have to use the different formula for this. Different formula for this. For this you have to use cylinder formula. For this you have to use spheres formula. And then add both of them. Then you get the total surface area or total volume. Whatever is required, you can find it out. So we'll do some problems. You will get, I think, about 7-8 marks in this. In your examination, final examination, you will get about 8 marks, I think, 7 to 8 or 9 marks. Because some portions are removed now, they will give some weightage for these. Extra weightage will be given for those portions which are remaining. Here, I have some papers, some old question papers. From that only I will solve. See here like this. A milk tank is in the shape of a cylinder with hemispheres of same radii attached to both ends of it as shown in the figure. Now, if the total height of the tank is 6 meters and radius is 1 meter, calculate the maximum quantity of milk filled in the tank in liters. Take pi is equal to 22/7, he says. Unless otherwise told, you have to take pi as 22/7 only. The value of pi is 22/7. Here, a milk tank, he has given a figure. The figure is like this. There is a milk tank. It is like this. Now the total height from here to here is 6 meter. 6 meter. And the radius is 1 meter. Radius is 1 meter. Here also it is 1 meter. Like this, if you remove this and this and join them, it becomes a sphere. So, this is center portion is a cylinder. This radius is 1 meter. This is 6 meter. Now, what you have to find out here is how much milk can be stored in that. That means we have to find the volume of the tank. You have to know that, what we have to find out. Now, here, volume of cylinder, that is the center portion, cylinder is equal to pi r square h. This is the formula for volume. Now, since we have got radius and length or height in meters, we are going to get it in cubic meters. Now, here r is 1 meter, h will be this much. That is, you will have to remove 1 meter here and 1 meter here is to be removed. So, the remaining is 4 meters. So, this will be 22/7 into r square, that is 1 square into h. H is 4. So that will be 1 square is 1 only. 22 into 4 is 88/7 cubic meters. This is the answer for volume of cylinder. That is this portion. This portion will be 88/7. Now, volume of sphere. Volume of sphere. The formula is 4/3 pi r cube. This is the formula. So, 4/3 into 22/7 into r cube. That is 1 cube. So, that will give me 88/21. 88/21. 4 into 22. 1 cube is 1 only. 4 into 22 is 8. 88. 88 into 1 is 88 only. 3 sevens are 21. So many cubic meters. Now, the volume of tank. Volume of tank will be this, if you call this as V1 and this as V2. Will be equal to V is equal to V1 plus V2. So that is 88/7 88/7 plus 88/21. There are two, this thing. The LCM is 21, 7 threes are, 3 into 88 you will get here, 3 into 88 plus 21 ones are 21, so you will get 1 into 88 here, that is 4 into 8, 32, 3, 32 plus 3, 35 divided by 21. This comes to how much 21 ones are, 21. Then there will be 14, 142. 142 means I think 6 times. If you divide, 352 divided by 21. 21 ones are 21. 5 minus 1 is 4, 3 minus 2 is 1. 14, I'll take this 2. I think 6 times it will go, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12. So 12 minus 6 is 6, 3 minus 2 is 1, 16. Then point 0, 21, I think 7 times. 7 times it will be, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. You will get 13, remainder. Then 13, 130, 130 means 5 twos are 5, 6 are 6, 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 4. I think there you can stop. It will be 16.676 cubic meters. Now he says, give the volume of the tank in liters. You know, 1 cubic meter is 1000 liters, so 16.76 into 1000, that is 16,760 liters. This is the capacity or the volume of this particular tank. Right? Like this, we will have to do. We can do some more problems. In the same paper, there is one more problem in choice. A cone is having its base radius of 12 centimeters and height 20 centimeters. Again, here also he has given the sketch. Sketch is given. You try this problem, I will not do it. This is a cone, it is cut here, this total height before it is cut, its vertical height is 20 meters. Here the radius is 3 centimeter. Here the radius is 12 centimeter. This is not 20 meters, this is 20 centimeter. Now what he says is, calculate the volume of the frustum. He wants you to calculate the volume of this frustum. That is, after you cut this, this is removed. What remains here is called the frustum. Now that will be, you have to find out what is the height that is reduced here. What is this height you will have to find out. And then find out the volume of that frustum. And this is another problem for 3 marks. You will do it. I think my time is up. 30 minutes duration I have completed, and therefore I am going to stop here, and I'll continue in the next